I'm Helen Dimaras, a scientist at the Hospital for Sick Children in Toronto, Canada.
And I'm Kaitlyn Huff, I'm a research manager at the Hospital for Sick Children.
We're here to tell you about our latest study entitled Knowledge, Experience, and Attitudes Concerning Genetics Among Retinoblastoma Survivors and Parents. Retinoblastoma is the most common type of eye cancer among children. It is caused by errors in a gene called RB1. People with retinoblastoma may be at increased risk not only for eye cancer, but second cancers later in life. Also, their children can inherit this gene error and develop eye tumors too. Therefore, it is important that families with a retinoblastoma diagnosis understand the genetics of their disease and what risks they may have, so that they can seek treatment in a timely manner.
We conducted focus group discussions to find out what individuals with retinoblastoma and parents of kids with retinoblastoma understand about genetics, how they have experienced it in their day-to-day lives, and what their views are on what the associated risks mean for them. Our results revealed that participants understood that retinoblastoma was a genetic disease.
It's a genetic form of eye cancer.
Retinoblastoma is caused by mutation in the RB1 gene.
Participants often misunderstood the implications of genetics on cancer phenotype and risk. For example, unilateral retinoblastoma, which affects one eye, can be heritable. However, this was lost on some individuals.
My belief is that with the unilateral, correct me if I'm wrong, but is that the secondary cancer risk is not there with the unilateral.
Experiences with genetic testing and counseling were generally positive. Testing and counseling was described as having provided clarity and relief or comfort.
With the genetic testing, my biggest fear was that it was affecting the other eye. So with the genetic testing, that was at least a relief off my shoulders, just to think, okay, at least she has her other eye. So I thought it might have come from me. I didn't know any better, so I just thought about it. But then I asked the doctor and she said no. She explained the whole thing to me.
Participants identified many challenges in receiving information from healthcare teams or it coming at a very stressful time and not being retained.
We definitely did undergo genetic counseling right in the height of it all. It's all a blur, but we definitely did.
Communication tends to be a bit of a problem where you're only given information at certain time frames and you don't know the direction where you're going or you don't know what's changed.
They reported challenges in accessing genetic information and psychosocial support.
My biggest challenge was, since we didn't tell many people, I had no one to turn to.
I think what could be helpful is if the hospital offered some sort of family counseling. In my family, there's a lot of through the grapevine and information can get distorted.
Participants described the need for educational resources.
Just an easy resource available. Here's that little pamphlet resource, whatever that one is, I don't know.
Maybe some kind of flowchart that starts, if you've had this, you will get this, you will get this, and then you know where you fall in the grand plan.
In summary, our study revealed that knowledge of retinoblastoma genetics is variable and often limited. Participants hold positive views of genetic testing and counseling, but require improved communication to expand their knowledge and improve psychosocial support to cope.
There is a need for further research into new methods that effectively communicate genetics to patients. As genetic technology advances and provides more information about our DNA, genetic communication will only become more relevant.
The patient perspective is important in this type of research and health service improvement going forward. In Canada, we have initiated a retinoblastoma patient engagement strategy to facilitate patient involvement in research and the co-creation of novel studies. Genetic communication may also be influenced by social, regional, and cultural factors. We have collaborated with clinician scientists in Kenya to perform the study with Kenyan patients and families, with results pending.
Thank you to the patient families who participated.